Let's do this before I chicken out.
Okay, I'm just going to do a quick pre-brief and then I'm going to mute my microphone and then you guys do your briefing and all your other stuff in the dark helicopters and stuff in global, please. Good evening, guys. Thank you very much for doing Operation Top Hat. I'm going to have a quick pre-briefing Q&A session with you guys to clear up any questions that you might have. Operation Top Hat is based on the Battle of Breach 14, which occurred during Operation Savannah in 1975. You can get a lot of information about that on the recce websites. When you do your briefing, I ask that you please do it on the map screen due to time constraints. If you go into the map itself, seeing that the mission starts at 5 o'clock and dawn is roughly at 5:45. Also, when you do your markings on the map screen, I see you did do it in global. Thank you. Please make sure that your markings are in global because the spectator view is civilian. Otherwise, I'm not going to be able to see it. With regards to your recon team, the recon team is at the CO's discretion. You do not have to let them clear the breach as well. If you have the numbers, you can use other members to clear the breach for the engineering team, and you're welcome to keep your recon team on the other side of the river or deploy them as you want. With regards to the observation team, it's also the CO's discretion where they should go. The observation point is just identified as the best point to observe the areas and to do recon on that area. But if you want to move the observer, you're welcome to move him. With regards to Delta Squad is there at the CO's beck and call. You can use your discretion on how to allocate them with the other units or make an own unit. They're completely at the CO's discretion. With regards to the Eland Squad, the two Elands, you're also by CO's discretion. You can use them and send them to the breach or to the RV point or return back to base. And you can also let them dismount and choose to drive the Elands yourself. Please note they do not have thermal or night vision inside of them. Your artillery, only the commanding officer can call in artillery. Artillery uses only 6-digit coordinates, and you only have 230 rounds available for the entire mission. With regards to engineers, ideally your engineers should not start building later than 06:15. Only the engineering team can shout commands, which are the blue commands when you scroll down. All others can give individual commands, which are the green ones. Shouting them to get cover will make them run and hide inside the bunkers. The bunkers are about 50 meters back from the breach to the right. The helicopters, you can use your own helicopter. You can fly your own helicopter if you wish to do so. However, if you wish to do the SADF flown helicopter, just scroll down when you get close enough to the helicopter, and then you'll get the options where to send him. Anybody close or inside the helicopter can order it to either go to the observation info, recon info, or base. The exfiltration helicopter that's waiting for the recon team will leave no later than 6 o'clock, but if you get there earlier and tell it to go, it will leave earlier than when you tell it. With regards to logistics, can use only the logistics that's approved as per the mission orders, and you can use everything that's been approved on the mission orders. The Eland troop is standing by in the town just south of the breach. You're going to use radio triggers, but be careful. Once you tell them to proceed, they will proceed, and you will not be able to call them back. So everybody is able to call the Eland troop to advance. That's the task for Zulu troop. But be careful, once you call them to advance, they will not turn back. With regards to the video, I'm going to record your spectator view. We are going to send you the basic submission video that we would like to see. You'll be welcome to add any other video material you wish before you submit your submission video to your YouTube channel. As soon as I'm done taking questions from you guys, I'm going to mute my microphone, which means you will not be able to hear me anymore. However, I will still be able to hear you. So if you run into any trouble, I'll still be able to hear you. If you're in the base, as long as nobody's left base, if you wish to restart the mission, I can still restart it. But once your guys have left the base, I will not be able to restart it anymore. That's it from my side. Questions?
Okay, Ox, when you're ready, do you want to give us a brief overview of the situation and objectives?
Yeah, all right. Guys, As you are aware, the battle group is scouting for other crossing points over the Niar River, and the politicians back home are not allowing reinforcements to further exploit our advance. The result is that the engineers have to put up a bridge across Bridge 14, and we are the only operational unit that can provide cover for them and allow them to get the bridge up so that a troop of Eland 90 armored cars can actually push north and start heading towards Luanda. As a result of the casualties that we took in Obsili, we only have 12 available operators for deployment. In order to achieve our objectives of creating a space for the engineers to rebuild Bridge 14, we need to attend to the following. Number one, we have to identify and eliminate enemy positions north of the river in the area stretching approximately 2 kilometers north of Bridge 14 and approximately 2 kilometers to the east and to the west of the bridge. Secondly, we have to provide close security for the engineers so that they can work without being overly hassled by dismounted groups or infantry in the area. Thirdly, we have to spot and direct counter-battery fire from our 5.5-inch howitzers onto any fixed positions. Four, we have to clear the road approaches north of the bridge so that the group of Elands can go through. We have intelligence that there are mines laid for a distance of approximately 200 meters on the far side of the bridge. Okay, guys, we are stuck with a reasonably strict time framework. Mission kicks off at 5 o'clock, and we should be back in the FOB at around about 7:30 a.m. So we've got approximately 2.5 hours to achieve multiple objectives and be back at the FOB. Okay, that's the background. Sultry, your turn.
Okay, thanks for that. Right, so before we get into actual map markings and routes, I just want to make sure everyone's clear with our unit layout. So we're going to have our observer team, Adam Chicken, your call sign Alpha. You guys will be moving in to set up your OP and get eyes on possible enemy positions as well as enemy artillery batteries in the area to call in support, artillery support from our side, and also to observe fire on the enemy artillery in order to give advance warning to the engineer team and recon team when they're at the bridge. We then have our recon team led up by Ox with Prime, Waylander. And for the first phase of the mission, which is their recon across the river, I'm going to attach Bandit from Delta to the recon team to make a four-man team. Okay, then we've got Charlie team consisting of Ginger and Morpheus. You guys are going to be tasked with keeping the engineers safe and also making sure to relay comms once the artillery fires to get them into bunkers and safe until those rounds hit. Then also, engineer team, you'll be tasked with demining the road north of the bridge once we've actually completed construction of the bridge. Delta team under me, we've got Killjoy, Para and Bandit. Para is our mortar specialist. He's going to be carrying the 60 mil and extra ammo will be split amongst Delta. Killjoy is going to be our squad doctor, so he's essentially going to be dealing with any more serious casualties we incur. We're going to set up a forward command post. I'll go into details about that later on. So essentially, with regards to the situation here, it is believed that enemies are concentrated on the northern side of this river only, but we are not to assume that the southern side is completely clear. If we reference the map, I've marked four areas of interest, or AOIs, Alpha through Delta, and when we actually push up to the bridge, we are going to sweep these areas first, both to make sure that there's no enemy ambushes waiting there for us, and also to help us get eyes on possible enemy positions north of the river, as they're elevated and should give us a good vantage point. For recon team and your initial objective, you guys will be dropped across the river northeast of the FOB And you guys are to proceed to a forward recon OP. Now, for any of the units crossing over, this includes the observer team. If you guys happen to make contact with the enemy, you are to disengage as soon as possible, because there's no ways that you guys can keep fighting over there. Just move back, get out if you can, and we'll make a contingency plan should that happen. Okay. We're going to be infiltrating in the dark, so you guys are going to have to make sure you keep track of your bearings and distance covered, and make sure you don't get lost and overshoot your waypoints. With regards to the enemy presence, intel's pretty limited, but basically there's a large number of communist-trained troops on the northern side of the river. Okay, believed to be some Cuban and Russian elements there as well. So keep your eyes open for that and relay any intel regarding the Cubans and Russians spotted. You need to relay that ASAP so we can get that through to the intel guys. Then we also have had mortar positions spotted in the area. It's estimated that there could be 4 to 8 mortar positions. BM-21s, Russian multiple rocket launcher systems, have been seen moving into the area. So we're looking at approximately 3 to 6 of those north of the river, okay? Then BRDMs have also been spotted in the area. And we're looking at having a few machine gun emplacements at least around the bridge on the northern bank. So we're going to have to try and spot those from further out before we move in and try and eliminate them either with mortars or artillery if we can. If we move to map markings now, we've got on the northern bank of the river, you can see I've marked some TRPs or target reference points. These are areas which I have felt are likely to have some sort of enemy presence at them. So essentially, I've named them with a letter of the alphabet, and next to that is the grid reference. What this is for is for quick target acquisition with the artillery. So if at any time any unit spots enemies on any of these locations, that to give me the reference point, and I can then drop 155mm rounds on there. I can pass the coordinates through to the artillery guys quickly. Okay, observer team, your guys' objective above all else is not to be detected. Okay, so, and to tell us when the artillery is firing, because without you, essentially, we're not going to have any idea that those rockets or mortars are coming in. So you guys need to relay that as soon as possible. Spotting actual targets for our artillery is secondary. Do not take unnecessary risks in order to mark targets for us. Recon team, same goes to you guys. If you hit contact at any time on your infiltration, you are to pull back immediately. If you cannot make it to the forward recon RV, you are to move to the emergency expo point and cross the river, swim across the river there, and we can arrange a pickup by vehicle for you there. With regards to casualties, should we be unfortunate to lose anyone, especially for the units who are operating north of the river, I suggest you bag him and you get him to a hiding spot and you make sure you mark that spot on the map, and we will come back and recover him at a later date, because it is not practical to expect you to cover a lot of ground with a body to the RVs, especially if you're far away. Okay, so bear that in mind. With regards to observer exfiltration, we'll see how the situation stands when we're at the end of the mission, and you need to give us your assessment as to whether you can actually get out from your OP. If you cannot get out from your OP to an RV location, we will leave you in place and arrange collection at a later date. So essentially, we're breaking this up into 6 phases. Phase 1 will be observer infiltration, which will happen at 0500. Okay, you guys are going to get dropped off by Puma at your observer info point. From there, you're going to proceed to your OP of your choice. You guys will see the lay of the land, and it's up to you to decide where you set up. And you just got to keep comms with me as you move. Keep me up to date with your progress. Then phase 2 of the operation will be recon team. You'll be moving out from HQ at approximately 5:15. And you'll be infiltrating into north of the river onto your forward recon infill marked on the map. Your guys need to make sure that you get to your OP and have enough time to return from your OP position to the recon RV. You need to make sure you get back there by 6 o'clock. I would suggest you need to get back there by 5:45 to make sure you've got a bit of wiggle room in case of surprises. So what's important is that you guys make it back to that RV, because we're going to need you for the push to the bridge. So if you see you're running short of time, call it off, pull back, we'll pick you up, and then we'll proceed with the main objective. Observer team, again, you guys need to make sure you're in position by 6, preferably by 5:45, since sunup is set for 5:45, and it's not going to be very safe for you guys to be moving around once the sun comes up. With regards to the rest of the team, I will be remaining at the FOB with Delta and Charlie teams. While phase 1 and 2 are underway, we will be loading supplies, ammunition, etc. into the trucks, which will be then be made ready for recon's return. Once recon has returned to the FOB, we will then push up together to the bridge and begin securing the bridge area for the engineer team. Charlie team will stand by at base with the truck and the engineers until Delta and Bravo have secured areas of interest, Alpha, Bravo, Charlie, and Delta. Then they will proceed up to the bridge and will commence bridge building operations. With regards to loadouts, make sure each team, each TL is responsible for making sure their team has at least one set of wire cutters, defusal kit,
radio.
Radio, obviously your TL, you need to make sure you pick up your radio before you leave, because that will be awkward. What was the other thing? We got defusal kit, wire cutters, and entrenchment tools. Yes, that's right. So we've got more than enough to go around. So I think... Right, we've got routes planned out for the bridge. This is an initial plan, and this could be changed at any time. As we know, situation is likely going to be very fluid, so we may have to adapt the plan as we go. But at least, you know, we've got this basic idea of what's going on. I think I've covered everything. If anyone's got anything to remind me on or any additions, now's the time to speak. This is it, guys. This is what we've been training for. This is what we've been preparing for. So I think we're good to go. Yep. Right, let's do this.
War dogs, war! Here we go, boys.
Charlie, so to get into a line out here, Alpha, head out, Chicken and Kratom, go get your backpacks and whatever you need. Start kitting up.
Okay.
Killjoy, can you move to the medical tent and make sure guys are reminded of what they're taking with medicals? You can grab a backpack on the way so that you can do your loadout as well. All right, Ox, off you go. Tents should be behind here.
I'm on you.
Waylander, are you going with them?
Yeah.
Ox.
Yeah. Okay. Bro,
is it?
Oh, come on.
Coming.
Okay. Go. Prom, you here? Right. Where's Waylander?
I'm here.
I've got the fuel.
Go. Ox, dude, come on. Good. We can be hot.
I can take something else if you want.
Affirm, we've got everything. Okay, copy that. Okay, guys, let's move out.
Make some space here quickly.
All right, good luck.
We're moving, Brian.
Yeah. Where did you go?
That way. Just hugging you for now, Sultry.
Yeah, just hook and stick with me. You're going to help me out with loading the trucks and stuff. Help the engineer guy.
Gute Nacht, mein Herz. Ich sag euch später nochmal gute Nacht.
Gerre, but it's dark. My eyes are gone, see shit.
Yes.
Fazit.
Hello.
Yeah, I'm on you now. Got a shadow on the light.
Gas, we give me the light. What's the other end?
Okay, Gas, let's go boat.
Gas, here the shots.
Yeah, no, no.
Guys, I'm night blind. I can't see my hands on my rifle.
Okay, we're coming in now. Got your ship. Got your ship, guys. Okay, we're landing now. Check your health.
Got injured when he got out.
No, he's got no injuries.
Guys, hold. Just stand still for a second. Just stand still for a second. Look at the south side, just in front of us. The fucking
Holy
mines.
Shit. Yeah.
It's what? Mines.
It's minefield. They've landed us in a minefield.
Fuck.
How the fuck are we gonna get? There's a road.
Let's go back towards the road, bearing 320.
Road is a problem, eh?
Yeah, let's just rally up by the road, Joe, right?
Alright, let's move this side, guys. Bearing 320.
Guys? Hello? Hello?
Ox, got you. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I'm behind the chopper.
Alright, Prime just got stuck there for a second, but he's good to go.
Okay.
Get on, yeah. Can't see
one,
shit.
2, 3. Okay, where's Wade?
On your six.
This side. Alright.
I can't see you guys. Nothing.
Okay, Bandit, can you take us out bearing bearing 60 for 2 minutes?
Alright, 60
for 2 minutes.
2 minutes on the dot. Okay, let me just get myself sorted here.
Okay, we were landed on a minefield. We've managed to extract ourselves from there. We're going to start pushing northeast now.
Sorry, boys, I don't know what's going on.
All right, guys, you say 2 minutes. Bearing.
Copy that.
Prime, it's all your UAVs for now.
2 minutes.
All right, starting now. Moving.
Okay, moving. Ox moving. Good, Prime?
I'm good, I'm on you.
Okay, Tom.
You got a fence?
Okay, copy that.
I lost you now.
Go, forward.
Anybody,
as a net, forward. I get you, Prime.
Getting up to, I've got a wire cutter, you want me to cut?
Yeah, cut.
Okay, just take it off the time, eh?
Yeah, stop the time. Why can't I cut this thing? Oh, there we go. Cutting the fence.
Captain Sobel, what's the holder?
Alright, we got a hold. We're still
yeah,
betting,
moving.
Still betting 60?
Yeah.
Okay. Right, everybody good?
Yeah.
Alright, moving.
I can't even cut any fence.
Hold up.
Bennett, holding on the side of the road.
Ooh, guys, those lights
are
dangerous.
We hit the 2 minutes, Bandit.
Not yet. We still got 54 seconds to go. You good to go?
Yeah.
All right, bearing 60, just alongside the road. Heading off, moving.
Okay, I've got Prime. How's it? Ox?
Yeah, I'm here.
Okay,
do you see the
saturation tower
towards the 60?
Here, boys. Found out something. I'm night blind.
Where's Bandit?
Look, I'm more than night blind. Bandit?
Got you. Just as they look, a stack.
Alright, this is 2 minutes on 60 degrees. Right here.
It's the fuck up. It looks like there's a bloody... There's a watchtower up here.
There's a watchtower.
Move forward.
I see it.
Bravo to command. Okay, We've got a watchtower blocking our path. We cannot see if it is occupied. I'm not sure if you want us to bug out or push forward.
Hang on.
Wait for daylight. Fuck.
It's empty.
Copy. Okay. My guys say it's empty. We can keep pushing.
Okay, which way are we going? Are we now waypoint 1?
Yeah. Yeah, confirm.
We got 50,
A firm.
50 degrees.
Okay, copy that. Yeah, I think let's just go straight north now for about 500 meters.
Another
straight north. 500 meters. What's the time on that?
3 minutes.
Three minutes
of a slow jog.
Confirm. 3 minutes. All right, good to go.
Go.
Good. All right, moving.
Okay. Send over. Okay, we are skirting around Hill 99, moving towards OP. Okay, I can't see that fucking T-junction on the... Oh, there it is. There
it is, right in front of us.
Yeah. Okay, so we can now turn and go bearing 310.
Copy that. Bearing 310.
Okay, road is clear.
Crossing.
Watching right.
Brian, het jy oor al gewond geraak in die donkerte? Ah. Het jy jou brille op? Jy het jou fucking brille op, seker.
Oh, Rock.
He's probably got his sunglasses on.
That's what it is, man.
So we have to go around to the rock.
Yesterday!
I've been smoking up in the fucking chopper. Hold on, let...
Okay, that's a 3 minutes up.
Well, guys, the beer's on me when we get
we
back
carry
to
on
camp.
Straight up, we'll be at the point.
Alright.
Send brother. We are halfway up the hill.
Ox, hold up, why is calling back?
Sorry, Prom?
Why is calling us back?
Can we mark that area?
Yeah, so it's 120 from the hill.
Yeah, it's bearing 120. If I range it with the binoculars as we were trained, if I take an estimate, we're looking at about 360 to 400 meters from here.
50 kills. And then op die verste kant van die suidooste, daar's een bunker. Maar ek kan nie sien wat daar binne is nie.
Okay, so you say about 400 meters, eh, Bandit?
Yeah, if I take the range, I get about, it's about half, about 5 miles, I get about 360 meters. So I would say 360 to 400 meters from our location. It looks about right, it's about halfway up that hill.
Confirm.
It looks good. Yeah.
Okay, we're working on a second vehicle now.
I think our range is good because it's about halfway up the hill.
Okay.
Okay, but you guys not?
You say you found the second vehicle.
Yeah.
Just on the other side of the road. Yeah, it's good.
Send over.
I'm just keeping eyes on this compound to
Bandit, you confirm it's a rocket launcher, eh? BM-21.
Russian organ, yeah.
Yeah, I'm not 100% sure that why call that one. The other one is a 50 kilo, it's not a vehicle.
Oxy Command, probabilities of it being a BM-21 are high. Hey firm, it's bunkered down, yeah.
I'm just checking out this compound to the south again.
Yeah,
I think it would be best
sleeping.
If you just drop salvos down once we are in the air.
Yeah. Should we not have a confirmation of downed?
Hey, firm, we just want to mark up the second one and then we'll get going. Out. Okay, where's the second one?
Looks like what a radar sense? Station on that copy. Bearing 155.
This is Scova. Yeah, this is Scova. So there's about three men here.
Way in, they're not behind us, yeah. Are we looking on time?
And I check. What light is it?
23 minutes to.
And it's at the base of that hill, huh?
So we need to. We're halfway on our time. We need to start moving back.
Yeah, we need to start moving. Let's go check them out, man.
Hang on, quickly, I just have to shift.
Ox, it's 23 minutes to 6.
Yeah, okay. Position is 065 049 exactly. Over.
And guys, my aesthetical blindness has gone away, I can see now.
Hey firm, we are bugging out. Okay guys, it's getting light, we better go.
Yeah, we need to get the fuck out of here.
Okay, is our job done?
Bandit, where are you?
Right behind you.
Okay, you want to take us out?
Hold on, we got vehicles moving.
Shit.
That's on our way back.
They're moving into position.
Bravo to command, just be advised, we've got vehicle movement between us and our expo.
It's soldiers. It's not vehicles, it's guys.
No, it's a patrol. It's a two-man patrol.
This is, don't turn on your lights, guys. That's the last thing that we want now.
Looks like a two-man patrol. Out.
Okay, guys, you know what, we're going to have to go for it, otherwise we're going to fuck out.
Going to get stuck. Those guys are about 600 meters out, 500
to 600. Okay, we need to move generally south, Bandit.
Copy that.
Let's just go for it. If we have to fight our way past them, then let's do it.
Otherwise we can go to the river and follow the river down.
Then we've got to sneak past this compound. Okay, let's do that.
Alright, so we're heading.
We're going to go to the river and then we're going to go around the far side of this hill and then head south.
Alright, so going bearing 220, 210.
Yeah, roughly. Right,
let's move. Oxum, can take it a little bit wider to the right.
Yeah, no, that's fine.
Are we in time?
It's now 22.
We've got 20 minutes.
Okay.
Fuck, when Jan said dead reckoning, he really meant it, eh?
Mm-hmm.
The rough estimate will make the chopper.
Yeah, we should make it easily.
Grr, we're gonna walk home. We're blue.
No, fuck that.
We've got about 6 to 8 minutes of movement to do in 20 minutes.
Yeah. Unless something horrible happens.
Yeah.
Just glad we're off that fucking rock copy there. There's no cover, no grass, no nothing.
No,
this is one fucking dry place.
This is probably the riskiest move we've ever made.
It looks like the dome at Paris. Fuck all grows there.
Just keep it quiet, we're close to this compound.
I apologize again for my fucking hysterical blindness.
Ja, als dein, je hebt weer zeker een andere schnappies gedrankt, nee.
Hey.
Hold, hold. Got a little Gato in front.
Copy, will do.
Just scanning
okay,
the area.
Can you see anything there, Bandit?
Picking.
Tower is clear.
I see torchlights, 12 o'clock. Bearing directly south. In the palm trees, you see that?
Yeah, I've got eyes.
Yeah.
Looks like it's
yeah,
a little, looks like
also
it's
see
a little
a broken
camp.
Vehicle there.
Okay, and then we have the coupe.
Yeah, let's move.
Are we still moving
go.
South?
Let's go.
Yeah, let's just maybe track a bit left again.
Okay.
We know where we are in relation to the river, so...
Where are we going? We're going to Recon RV?
Yeah, we're going to the Recon Exfil. RV, yeah.
There's a fence in front of us. Must probably a compound.
Yeah.
Just keep eyes after the net for that patrol.
Yeah, there's the fence that we cut.
You can see the hole. The hole is right in front of us.
Out there again.
Bandit, we can go back through the same hole, huh?
Oh, say again?
We can go back through the same hole. It's up front in front of us.
Okay.
I know you shouldn't really flip and track on your own path, but still.
No, that's why somebody's following us, we can kill them.
Yeah. This is true as well. Bandit, go between those two big rocks next to the fence. We can check things out from there.
Now can I see where we were running, mate?
That looks like a radar tower or something up there.
Yeah, I called it when we were on the mountain.
Hold. There's movement up on that little hill, right straight up.
Yeah, what do you make that? Hill 75? Yeah. Bravo to command.
Ja, vat die fucking ding uit. Enige ding wat gecamouflage is in Angola is sommer kak.
I think we found an enemy command post or.
Radio
perhaps a radio or a radar installation coupled with it at coordinates 0723-0358.
Are you moving?
There's a little bit more left.
No,
we can just climb the fence. Okay, it is marked as Hill 75, holding for coordinates. 0737.
Yeah, my stuff is so fucked up.
0358. Hill 75.
Cutting the fence, bro.
Thanks. There we go. Through. Thanks.
That's safe.
We're good to go, Oct.
That is correct. We're moving on.
Are we still going straight south?
Oh shit, what's this in front of us?
Yeah, fuck.
Oh fuck! BMP!
Oh fuck. Yeah, that's stuck. That's where we landed, guys. That's where we landed.
Oh, it's fucked. It's fucked.
No, they're dead.
That's where we landed.
Yes, sus.
That's initial landing zone.
There's a tent with a camo net over it. And what appears to be a big pole sticking up.
And the landmine field. There's a landmine field as well.
On set, that is so far at ons
geland. They're abandoned.
Yep.
Yeah,
point me in a direction.
That's initial landing zone, guys.
So, where's
so we need to go southeast now, till we hit the road.
Southeast. Going bearing 230.
We got 10 minutes, guys.
Okay, let's get cracking. Let's go, guys, southeast.
Mind the minefield.
Oh, fuck yeah.
Go this side of the road. Yeah, bandits coming again. Yeah.
Okay, guys, let's swing southeast. Send over. We're picking up the pace, we're about 400-500 meters out, we've still got 10 minutes. Yeah, AFM. Yeah, copy that.
Bunker on the hill.
Yeah, I saw it, it's empty as well.
Bunker up it.
Another fence.
You're gonna have to cut it again. The old man can't fucking climb the fences.
Copy. Cutting.
Thank you. Good to go.
Okay, we're gonna have to swing almost directly east.
Guys, just watch out. I've got a bunker on my top side.
Yeah, right. Same thing. We saw it.
Okay. Ox. Ox, let me take point.
Yeah, okay. Almost, almost east. Just hold it to just to the right of east.
Copy that.
Down to 7 minutes.
Lapped on niemand.
Yeah. Let's go fast, jog, guys.
Why am I hearing paranoia?
On Oxus radio.
Bunker, okay. Bunker.
Oh, it's on the radio. Push.
Empty. About 6 minutes.
Okay, Ox to command, we're about 300 meters out. Okay, there's a helicopter just in front of us.
Nice.
Let's check for an ambush, guys. Might have seen it landing.
Ox to command, you should try it on this side. Out. How's your stamina, guys?
Almost done.
I'm good.
The weapon is pulling behind.
Okay. Coming up. Oh. Stamina fucking you up, what?
Yes.
All the extra kit you got.
I think I'm under 30 still. So. A sight for sore eyes.
Yep.
Okay, go away, go. I'll keep.
Okay, guys. Okay. Let's mount up, Wayne. Okay, one in.
Move west.
Bandits in.
Prime's in.
Move west.
To Bravo. Yep.
We are dusting off now. Okay, we're coming into that.
I think all in all we did okay, even with my hysterical blindness, fuck.
Yeah, no, we did very well, I think.
Yeah, you guys gonna lock when you see Mark, because I had a head cam on. They were fucking pitch dark.
put on. Yeah, bud.
There.
Follow the sound.
Yeah, follow the sound of the gunfire.
Well done, guys.
I was totally expecting us to get fucking
fucked. I'd like to know, I spotted the with the RT fire.
Yeah, those were the rounds going out on our targets.
Yeah, but I think it was a good call that they only fire once we were out of there, else they might have fucking...
Yeah, I told them to wait until we're in the air.
Woken up a whole fucking hornet's nest there.
We're probably doing it right now.
Yeah, well, I was worried that we were just going to get swarmed if they fire.
Well, I took a dump behind a rock there, so they can find it.
Speaking of which, I've got such a big sun board, I'm crossing my legs here while we're running.
You had an hour before the time, but...
Yeah, and I clean forgot because I flew instead.
Right, lads, get your stuff
back.
Sorted.
Was that an incoming?
Get in the Land Rover.
Say again?
Get yourself sorted if you're not sorted, and then afterwards just get in the Land Rover if you're done.
Okay. We can go straight.
Copy that.
Yo, Bandit. Thanks, buddy.
Cool, I'm going to
go and help Mera.
Yeah.
Okay. Good stuff.